Oh, yeah, car seat.
Nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong moral compass. You just need to think your way out of it. Oh, fudge!
I'm sorry!
What's she doing?
I think she's spouting euphemisms at us. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage to accelerate to 88 miles an hour anytime soon.
How are we gonna stop her?
She said any hour, anytime soon.
Good question. We can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle.
Messed up the text.
The timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights my alternate self went all over. The DeLorean have given me an idea.
Yeah, why is Doc so quiet? I can barely hear him.
What are these?
Flux synchronization modules.
How do they work?
I generally use them for maintenance purposes. We might be able to use them to sync up the alternate DeLorean's diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time circuits and override the time destination of the alternate.
Speak up!
At least that's the theory, anyway.
That's a great plan, I think.
Best of all, we won't need to weld the modules to the frame. We'll just snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that?
Modules, huh?
Let me think.
Aha!
Oh, nice! The hoverboard!
It saved our hides a few times before, so it seemed like
sweet.
The appropriate tool to bring along for the job.
Sweet!
Marty said the same thing I did. That's funny. I freaking love the hoverboard. Alright, so we have to somehow use these devices Doc gave us, I guess, to sync up the...
You okay?
The flux capacitor on Enna's DeLorean to ours? That's weird.
Ready to make the jump?
Ready, Doc.
Alright, here we go.
1, 2, 3, jump!
Oh, shit. There you go.
Nice form, buddy. Counter reception on the wireless.
Great. Where'd you get these?
From Burns Cache, a 21st century video game console. Now remember, all you've got to do is attach the flux sync module.
Video game consoles.
Will do, Doc.
Guess what, Marty? I have not a wireless, but I have a wired microphone right now. I'm talking to you right now. Stop Enna from escaping through time. All right, we got a. Doc gave us these flux overriders. I'm not sure how to put them yet. I guess we'll figure it out. So, what do we do? Flux emitter.
Is that one of the flux emitters?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sink.
Okay, so we plug in one of these flux overrides on there.
I can't reach it from here.
Oh, shit.
We just have to climb onto the top.
How the hell are we gonna do that? Mr. Fusion?
Mr. Fusion! Should I disable it?
Leave it alone. It's not a good idea to monkey with nuclear reactors.
I'm sorry!
Okay. Let's... Oh, there's one in the front, too? Let's go to the front bumper here. Oh, crap. She doesn't see us.
I can't talk to her from here.
That's probably a good thing.
Is this the starboard flux emitter?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sink.
Alright, let's try one of our flux overrides on here. It worked.
Alright.
Nicely done. Now, aim the
sink
toward the receiving dish.
How the hell do I do
I'll
that?
I'll try, but it's getting a little bumpy out here.
Alright, how do I aim it? Shit! Let's try that again. He broke off something? It looked like Marty broke off. Oh, he did. Windshield wiper. I'm sure that's gonna come in handy. Alright, let us...
I can't talk
Alright, I don't want
to
talk to her. I want to aim this thing. There you go. Oh my god, this is harder than I thought. Oh, there you go, we got it. That's pretty fun, actually. That's a cool minigame. Ah!
That's one flux sink down.
Two to go. Well, there's one on the top here. We can't get to that one yet, I'm assuming. Unless... Let's get to the front bumper. Shit. Whoa. Marty, get out of there! Oh my god. We're gonna die. Whoa. Oh crap! That can't be good. Oh shit. Shit, shit, what have I done?
Don't cross those flames, they may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing through normal flames.
We gotta get to the other side now, right?
It's locked!
Damn it! And, or I guess we just have to cross through the front again. Damn it!
Marty!
I'm okay.
How do we cross the back?
Don't cross those flames, they may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing through normal flames.
Gotta... Alright, we gotta stop the flames.
Your fusion belching flames!
Yes, that's unfortunate. I'd stay out of it if I were you.
Oh, wait, I got an idea. Windshield wiper. Fix it. Put it back. There you go. There you go. Now we should be able to get back here. Sweet. Alright. Driver's side. I'm assuming there's another one of those flux things or whatever on this end. Hey, Ed. You don't see me.
Made it.
There you go.
Now let's get that flux on the right module before she starts making life difficult.
She's been making it easy up till now?
Yep. Alright. We're on the other end. Flux emitter! Activate!
There goes nothing, Doc.
Must seek.
Whoa!
I think that's what we're doing. We're
sinking
her DeLorean to Doc so that when Doc travels through time, it'll take Edna with us, I think. I think that's what's going on here. This is harder than it looks, folks. Shit. There you go. Two. Alright, that's
we're
two.
We're almost home, Marty. Just one flux seat left.
Just gotta get to the top.
Get off my car, you hooligan!
Who are you calling a hooligan? Alright, how do we get up there?
It's one of the flux emitters.
I know, we just have to get that last one going, and we will be good to go. Shit!
I can't reach it from here.
How do we get on top? Edna!
It's locked!
How the hell do we get on top? Edna! Oh, we can actually talk to her, I think, right?
Edna!
What? Yep.
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Ah! We got this! Oh, okay!
Are you alright?
Okay!
Not really!
No, it's okay. We got this.
I can't reach it while the window's shut.
We need to get on top.
What?
Pull over!
No!
Pull over! There you go!
Excellent, Marty. Now that you're on top of the
board,
attach the flux sink to the overhead flux emitter.
It's great, Doc.
Hell yeah, it's great. All right, we got this. This is dangerous. Marty's putting his life at risk, but he's done that all game anyway, so. Attach it. There.
Nicely done. Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish.
We got this. Oh, this one's like backwards. That's kind of cool. Shit. There you go. We did it! All three are synced, Doc. Get us the hell out of here.
Get out of there, Marty.
I'll try. Give me my hoverboard back. Yeah, boy! Doc saves us again. And we'll no longer be able to go 88 miles per hour!
Now we take the
unless we take
her
88 miles an hour.
That's strange.
What?
According to these readings, the temporal cohesion on Edna's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, that Doc.
Mean? We've got to get Edna home. Now!
Let's do it! 88 miles an hour?
Hold on!
Yeah, baby, you're coming with us! No more burning down speakeasies or burning anything down. Oh, shit! Oh, damn! That says she's dead. We killed her. Yeah! We did it! We got her out of, at least we got her out of that, 1800s. Ah, shoot. So what happens now? I wonder. It's pretty epic. I think she's dead. She broke the game. It's a very long loading screen, so I think she broke it. Uh-oh. Edna? Edna! Oh, she's still alive.
Parker? Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
What? No! You can't arrest me! Not now, I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are.
Time traveler.
I'm loving this.
I'll prove it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Unhand me, you dolt.
Oh, man.
Well, I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
So
what
true.
What do you do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
What the hell?
Nice.
Hey, Parker, you're not gonna believe this.
See? What did I say? Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc! The timeline's not fixed yet. Look!
Oh god, now what? Oh yeah, Artie. He mentioned that he screwed up and his...
Sorry! You missed all the fireworks at the expo! Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da! Artie took me to Reno last night!
No.
Try to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
That's not...
Well, you're gonna congratulate us or what?
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma.
Yeah, why is Marty still here?
Hey, are you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
You're too young.
Artie, you can't do this. You're not supposed to get married for another 5 years.
Well, I know Trixie and I were taking things slow.
But after that witch Edna got me fired with that postcard, we kind of accelerated things a little.
Oh, accelerated.
Oh, man.
She's the wrong woman!
Trixie, you can't marry Artie.
Is this about my past with Kid? Because Artie ain't holding that against me.
That's right, darling.
Yeah, plus she has big boobs.
The past is the past. Yeah, but... Can you see through me?
No, Marty, you're right.
Never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
What?
You didn't think my
what?
Real name was Trixie Trotta,
oh,
did you?
Oh my god, really?
Feel too bad. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute, your grandma Sylvia?
Oh, jeez.
Hey, how old do you think
and you
I
saw
am,
her naked,
kiddo?
Oh.
But you're so, so skinny and blonde and, huh.
Yeah,
you know,
it's
I
amazing
think
what
I
oh my
like
god.
You as a
Sylvia. I've seen you naked.
That's what I said.
You're Sylvia?
Oh.
You okay,
Marty
pal?
And the thing yeah. is...
I'm fine.
Poor
great.
Marty.
You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around.
Speaking
come
of which...
Come around to what? To approving your marriage.
Yeah, Michael
you
J. Fox.
You seemed kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her, I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
Daddy!
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
That's all I've been doing since I've been back in time.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Callahan.
Agent Callahan.
See you in the funny papers, Harry.
Bye, Grandma.
Bye, Grandma.
You know, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
That's my grandma you're talking about.
Well, I think we finally did it. We finally fixed the timeline. I didn't think it was possible. It was so much work. So much work. 5 episodes worth of work. We did it. We saved Duck! Sorry. I'm okay. Home sweet home. Thank God. Man, this game has been amazing.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
It sounds like it's ending. I can tell. I mean, it seems like it's coming to a close
still
now.
Going on. Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale? You mean...
Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures,
calls
eh?
Calls him Doc, too?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for?
Yeah, I sure did.
Great! Hey, is that a box of Asimov?
Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists? Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you.
What is it? It feels good to be home. Back in good
Happy
old 1985, 86, 84, whatever.
That's not for another. The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done.
Wait, so that's why he went back in time.
Which is why you traveled back to
yeah.
1931 to look for her.
Exactly.
I thought it was for a selfish reason.
Speakeasy on her stage name.
This is great, Doc. Thanks.
It's the least I can do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Brown!
Oh my god, it's Edna.
Edna?
What the hell?
Tiny!
What's going on? What are you doing at my door?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much-needed exercise.
She hates
isn't
dogs.
Isn't that right, Einstein?
Uh-oh.
Hey, dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
No!
Coming, sweetie! Oh, Mr. McFly,
have you seen
my stepson anywhere?
She married Kim Tannen.
I think you're late for an appointment.
What?
Gosh, you're right, Mr. McFly.
Hi, Marty.
What the hell is going on here?
Don't they make a great little family? You never know, they met in prison.
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly into the lab and hope there are no more surprises.
You know what? I hear you. Just leave it. Leave the timeline alone. Oh my god. As long as everything else is okay, that's all that matters. Thank god. I think it's over now. Yeah, so I guess that's the end of the game, right? Wait. I spoke too soon. What is this? Oh no! What the hell?
Doc!
Marty! What are you doing here?
You gotta come with me! Back to the future!
Marty, you can't be here!
No.
If your younger self sees you, the consequences could be catastrophic!
What the hell?
My younger self? Oh, right! Bring him along too! This concerns all of us!
What do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Nah, we're fine. But our great-great-grandkids?
What the hell?
Great Scott!
What the hell is going on here? What the hell?
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Back to the... Listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you wanna save Jennifer and our 12 kids.
What? 12 kids?
That timeline was overwritten 5 jumps back.
Doc,
Jennifer's out of
how
picture.
Can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea.
This is crazy.
Well, the space-time continuum should be tearing Doc apart like a cheap dish rack right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up.
Oh my
you
god.
Gotta come with me to save it. No, me.
What the hell?
So,
what the
we meet at last. You've altered my timeline once too often.
What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands. Or 3.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
This is like a homage to Back to the Future 2. I love it. But
come on.
Prepare to be erased. Doc, wait. What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future
and mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.
Is that the end? That is the end. Wow. Oh, God. Well, guys. Oh, God. I gotta lower the music. Well, guys, I don't know what to say. This has been a hell of a game. Now, I'll be honest with you. I wasn't too crazy about the ending over there. Oh god, please somehow skip this. Now, so here's my overall assessment of the game, okay guys? I absolutely loved... Let me think about this. Episode 1 I felt was pretty good. Episode 2 I felt was my favorites was actually episode 4. I think 3 and 4. Yeah, well, you know what? They were all good, okay? I really enjoyed playing this game. Now, I know it wasn't an LP for everybody, but for a blind game, I was very impressed, especially since it's very hard to get me into games nowadays, you know? But yeah, it was great. The only thing I'm a little nitpicky on is I was hoping for a conclusion, like an ending or some, I don't know. I guess I was just looking for something else at the end that I didn't get. But overall, I can't criticize. I mean, a lot of the puzzles did get tedious at times, but otherwise, The story was amazing, and a lot of the parts of it was fun, so I guess this concludes my Back to the Future Let's Play, and I gotta say, I know they're talking about a sequel, but I think this game's perfect. I don't really think you need a sequel to this game, you know? So, that concludes this. I had a ton of fun let's playing this game, and now we move on. God of War Trilogy continues soon. How soon? I don't know yet. Maybe as little as tomorrow soon, but I'm not going to promise anything yet because I still have to play it and catch up to that point I left up on, you know? So, we end it here, folks. Thank you so much. It's been a blast. And until next time, or in their next Let's Play, well, see you guys then. I love you all. You are the best viewers in the world. The Michael J. Fox Foundation for Parkinson's Research. Well, they even put that in there. That's kind of nice of them. I feel bad for Michael J. Fox, you know, because the guy was such an amazing actor, and he just can't do it anymore because of his situation, but I'm glad they added him in this game as a little homage, you know? All right, guys. See you guys later. A+. I recommend this game, definitely. Great story. Maybe not the funnest gameplay in the world for a lot of you, but I had fun with it, so yeah. Thank you. Adios, amigos. And really, to be continued, no, just end it. You don't need to continue it. Later, guys.